definitely a trend which has to be taken as part of the curriculum itself. See, if you see the history of education, right, all of you have passed several stages, right, in college. And what you study there serves as an important base for you when you come to the industry, right? So we also see several cases of, okay, people who kill a lot of people in wars are tainted as heroes because of history, how things are taught actually. So we firmly believe if things are not taught the right way in colleges, in universities, then it's a big problem actually. So we wanted to first make sure that Agile is a happening thing. Okay. And the good news is Agile is definitely a great trend actually, which is the conclusion.
ఇక్కడ
ఎనీబడి హూ హ్యాస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ వెన్ ఐ కమ్ టు సెకండ్ పార్ట్ కెన్ రేజ్ వన్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ హ్యాండ్స్ ఎనీబడి హూ హ్యాస్ సజెషన్స్ బోత్ పార్ట్స్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ ఇస్ ఇఫ్ యువర్ సజెషన్ ఇస్ గుడ్ రైట్ వి డైరెక్ట్లీ టేక్ ఇట్ టు ద కరిక్యులం దిస్ ఎలెక్టివ్ ఇస్ అబౌట్ టు హ్యాపెన్ టు అ లార్జ్ సెట్ ఆఫ్ స్టూడెంట్స్ సో దట్ వే యు బికమ్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ కాంట్రిబ్యూషన్ ఇండస్ట్రీ అకాడమిక్ కాంట్రిబ్యూషన్ సో పార్ట్ 2 ఇస్ వేర్ ఐ విల్ లుక్ ఫర్ సమ్ సజెషన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ యు A brief introduction about me. Okay, so I worked in around 11 countries actually. For the last 6 years, I've been in Agile consulting. See, what happens is we have an MTech software engineering course in National University of Singapore. Many times, right, when we do student introduction, when I go for the first day, right, see, there are around say 600 students. What happens? Some of the students put hands and then tell me, "Are you from KE or SE? Meaning, are you doing knowledge engineering or?" Software engineering. They mistake me to be a student among them because all the faculty members are 50 plus and the kind of profiles who work in my department, right? Oxford PhDs, Stanford PhDs. I am kind of an anomaly there for a specific reason because I am from industry, okay, having a lot of Agile experience, Scrum professional, Agile certified practitioner, but this is not my core focus. My core focus is social networks research, Agile project management research, which I am also teaching there. See, whenever we meet, right, I think we may be here for 45 minutes to 1 hour, and at the end of the session, no, if I don't know even one of your names, then it's little harsh on you and me as well, right? So I thought we'll do a very brief introduction, just the names actually. How it will happen is, I'll tell my name, second person will tell my name and his name, and then we'll continue quickly, okay? We have less people here anyway.
There's only two, right? You don't want the last person to repeat all the names.
Yeah, see, generally people who come to my classes, right, and who come late and who sit at the last get hurt. Because we have around, see, my batch, we have around 80 students, and then the 80th person generally suffers, because the introduction goes that way. So maybe we'll start quickly. Jagadish.
Yeah. Jagadish and Bharat.
Bharat.
Jagadish, Bharat, Samya.
Okay.
Jagadish, Bharat, Samya, Rashma.
Okay.
Jagadish, Bharat, Samya, Rashma, and Prabhakar.
Jagadish.
Samya, Rashma, Prabhakar, and Abu Thomas.
Abu Thomas. Okay.
Jagadish, Bharat, Samya, Rashma, Prabhakar, Abu Thomas, Prabhakar.
Prakash, Ramesh, Arvind.
Arvind. Your name?
Jaydeep, Ramesh, Arvind.
He's taking a shortcut. Maybe you can try.
This was yours, Jagdish Ravindra.
Okay, see, your name, sir, please, rest of you.
Anuradha.
Anuradha. You, sir?
Anushu.
Okay. Leave. But the teacher was very harsh. She never spoke in English. Okay, right from the introduction of the name, it used to happen in German. Wie heißt du means, what's your name? So all I had to tell was, Ich heiße Jagdish. My name is Jagdish Anjali. But she would never allow me to do this in English. Okay. She will not tell, Wie heißt du means, what is your name? Okay, then no, one day, after a month, right, when I started clearing the first level, I caught hold of that lady. Her name is Helga Samuel. I told, see, this is too much. You definitely have dropouts here using this kind of a method. She told, learning a language is not about interpreting it, okay, in your own language. For example, my name, I interpret it in English, okay, and then I understand how it is in German, and then I told. That's not the way it's going to work out in the long run. If she told me, if you are going to learn something, you have to start thinking in that language. Okay? Agile also, right? If you want to do something in agile, right, you have to be agile. You have to believe in being agile. Okay? One of the reasons why I am here is some of you, at the end of the session, if you feel no, you are very skilled in a particular area where you can come and train, okay, you are welcome to do it in case that's a very unique topic which is of interest to me actually, and then it's subject to the board's approval, then we work together. So it's that way. I'll tell you what is the model of working. A background is right, NUS was around, the ranking was around 70-80, National University of Singapore. See, it climbed several places. So this is a miracle actually. Several places, now it's in top 30. Okay. Because, let me take the M.Tech software engineering curriculum as example. I would say one of the best software engineering research labs we have. One other example, see, nobody will be bold enough to come out with their curriculum and then open it for criticism. I'm going to show the course design of one of our agile curriculum. I'm going to ask you to criticize. Okay, see, we are that way. Okay, we are very open to the feedback from the industry. We are very open to tuning things further. So that way, one of the best universities, even the faculty pool, right? We have 120 faculty in the department from 40 different countries. So that kind of background. So inside NUS, there is a specialized department. Inside National University of Singapore, there is a specialized department called Institute of System Science. So I come from the Institute of System Science, where we run a program, M.Tech Software Engineering program, for industry practitioners, people like you exactly. People who are having a lot of industry experience, but then they want to come back to school, part-time, full-time, learn new skills actually, learn new methods. So those are the target audience. All our faculty pool have rich industry experience. Say minimum 15 to 20 years of experience in industry, then only they come into academics. Okay. But of course, they also have heavy weightage of doctoral degrees like Stanford PhDs, Oxford PhDs. They have an academic base and also an industry strength. Okay. So we offer multitude of courses facing industry as well. Purpose of this class, as I said, is to share the experience of transforming M.Tech. It's not an easy journey. See, if you imagine an organization, right, where you are working among 100 people, you want to do an agile journey there, how difficult it is. Okay, whereas in this situation is even more harder because the syllabus was framed in 1996, it was updated to an extent actually, but then it's been many, many, many years. If you have to completely change it the agile way, so the challenges are there. If you are thinking what's in it for you from this session, and if you are trying to get an anchor or a clue on what this guy is trying to speak about, see, it's about building bridges. So understanding how the students are prepared for the agile world actually. Okay. Again, student is not a student who comes and does an M.Tech or a B.Tech or whatever. Students are people like you, people who take up short courses, people who see some industry focused curriculum. We also want to share a framework for an agile journey, how it can be done. We also expect some criticism on the courses we are trying to design. And you can do make a lasting soul-fulfilling contribution at the end of this class. If you say, no, this particular thing will not work, maybe I'll take the feedback, retune the course, and then offer it to public. So that's the intent. see, let's do a 1 minute exercise before moving on. All you need to do is mentally. You need to draw a circle, draw a rectangle inside the circle, and then draw a triangle inside the circle.
Okay.
If you have a notepad, right? Maybe a couple of you can draw it and then I can look at the solution. It's an independent exercise. See, you are solving complex problems in industry. All I'm asking you to do is take a very simple problem, draw a circle, draw a rectangle inside the circle, draw a triangle inside the circle. Assume I am your customer, ready to give you 1 million. If you give the solution that I want. So, what's your solution going to be? Done? I think he likes temples. Yeah. Okay. Any other solutions from anybody? Okay, I think that's enough. See, I've seen three. Okay. And looks like this person is applying for a housing loan.
I completed
it. You completed it? Great. Congratulations. Yeah, I'm still paying. See, this person, yeah, maybe a temple goer or whatever.
Yeah.
See, the idea is, okay, this is a totally different solution altogether, right? See, such a simple problem, right? We have given it to 10 of you. Why 10 different solutions? Can you tell me?
There are multiple possibilities.
Okay.
There are solutions.
Okay, see, going from here to the airport, are there multiple possibilities?
Yes.
Okay, so any problem, and any solution, moving from a problem domain to a solution domain, are there multiple possibilities? Always yes, right? Always yes, right? There is no situation where there is only one loop to close the solution. Okay, but I am the customer here. If 10 of you are giving 10 different solutions, okay, I am not impressed, right? Of course, I am not going to work with 10 of you. See, sorry, meaning what's going wrong here? Because the specification is not clear, you may tell that. Correct, right? Or you didn't interact more with me. Maybe draw a circle. Agile is about what? Failing fast, right? Nobody stopped you after you draw a circle. You could ask me, no? See, Jagdish, is very unclear. Do you want me to put a rectangle here or in the corner or in the center? Okay. See, the great agile lessons, right, can be taught in the class for one day at a time or in a simple exercise. So this is agile. Why didn't you fail fast? You could have drawn a circle, come back to me, asked where to put the rectangle. Many times your customers work in different geographies. In this case, I am right in front of you. Being agile is as simple as this. Okay. So the entire concept of agile can be bottled in a feature called failing fast. Are you willing to fail fast? Okay. This solution, try to relate it to my problem. I am the one running all the agile initiatives inside Institute of System Science. Okay. There are several institutes, like Institute of Southeast Asian Studies, where Singapore president, right, who just retired, S.R. Nathan, you might have heard of him, great gentleman, actually he's a teacher there. I'm just trying to give you a comparison profile. Okay, so when I'm dealing with this kind of institutes, when I'm the person who's going and selling Agile, and then when I'm trying to convince them that Agile will work, okay, you have to imagine what is the kind of people I'm facing. Okay, they are very old, because in academies there is no retirement, right? The older you are, the wiser you are, and then the more you are needed actually. It's not like industry, kind of an use and throw atmosphere is never there in academies. Okay, I am not against industry because I am also from industry. So if your skills are outdated in industry, right, you may not find a place. Whereas in academics, right, if your skills are outdated, you may be wanted more, because chances are nobody will have that skill inside the department. You possessed it for 20 years. Now nobody has that. You are the person who is going to redo things in a different way. See, my challenges were, right, each faculty has separate offices. For example, I have an office half size, half this room. Okay, seriously. So if there are 40 faculty members, we have separate lock and doors. It's not like IT where there are seats, we sit together. So when I come, when I go, what I do, nobody knows. So that's why I am trying to tell each faculty are in their individual universes. Assume all of us are faculty members in NUS. We have separate facilities actually. It's like a separate company in itself. and the context is Greek and Latin. We have people like Dr. Pallab Sahar, who is one of the best in enterprise architecture. We have people like Swarnalatha Ashok, one of the best in research actually. And each person doesn't know their subject. Okay, they are the best in their own areas. When we say we have to transform our curriculum to the agile way, all these people come and teach, right, their modules. Everything has to move. For example, agility is there in architecture. Agility is there in project management, right? So agile comes everywhere. So how to put all these people together and then do a transformation journey? That was a very big challenge I faced. Okay. How did I overcome it? I'll also let you know. See, some MTech background, as we said, we do a part-time course and also a full-time course. Full-time is straight. Okay, 1.5 years. You come, in 1.5 years you finish it and go. Part-time is minimum 2.5 years. It usually happens on Saturdays. Okay. We have 4 core software engineering courses, 8 electives, 3 advanced electives, which forms the MTech. Why I am giving the background is you need to know it to really know what is getting transformed from a university perspective. Okay, core courses are introduction to software engineering, software design, software project management, software quality management. There are several electives. Okay, and then some advanced electives as well. How it is structured is this way. See, full-time students, part-time students. Let's take the case of a full-time student. Okay, assume I am joining in January for a full-time course. I'll do unit 1 and 5, 2 and 6, I'll go this way. When I come into somewhere around the second semester, right, July to November, I'll start doing a project which will be for 9 months. Okay, imagine this is happening the waterfall way. Okay. Waterfall concepts are taught in core courses. When I do my project, I do it the waterfall way. Six students go and get attached to industry. They do the project that way. Okay, now what we are trying to do here is we are going to tell, no, this has to be agile. Don't teach waterfall anymore. We are trying to convince them, remove this, put agile curriculum. The student project will have to be executed to agile way. Okay. So what is impact? Impact is to thousands of students, right? And now several people we teach are CXO level people as well. Okay, because there is no end to learning as well, right? Some people don't come back to school for learning a particular technique. They come for pleasure. Because, see, assume, no, in one batch, there are students from 24 countries, right? So you get to know them, get to know different cultures, lot of things actually. So transformation is, according to me, a very, very difficult challenge compared to an organizational transformation journey. Any questions so far? See, I'm not using the mic because audience is less and then it will echo. Right? See, some of the questions I had in mind are, I talked about the core subjects, right? Should core subjects be taught using existing waterfall methodology and RUP methodology, which is a rational unified process? Should core subjects be taught using agile? Should student projects be done the agile way? Questions in elective subjects, do we need new electives on agile? If the answer to the above question is yes, what are the new courses? Okay. If agile is just a hype, for all of these questions, answers will be no, next 15 minutes, and then I can go back happily. Because, right, if you see, we are partners with ThoughtWorks. ThoughtWorks is one of the gold sponsors here, right? One of the best organizations for agile. They have something called a technology radar, where, no, if you get to know it, right, about 140 technologies can be mapped together in one go. Very interesting method they have. All the 140 technologies are not happening today. See, each new technology which comes up, right, it has a life, it dies away. Assume agile is a buzzword today. Assume you start following it today, you get a job as an agile manager or whatever. In 3 years, it's dead. Then what happens? Right? If it is that kind of a trend, we don't want to change our curriculum. Very clear. But then if it is something which is going to affect the way work is done in software development in a fundamental way, then we are going to change our curriculum. So it's a very important decision making process we did. And remember, the faculty pools we had are experts in their own area. If I go and tell them, no, you have to change your curriculum the agile way, no, they are definitely going to question us back. So the kind of data we go with should be that powerful.
I have a question. When you say RUP, rational unified process, is the same as agile technology, agile methodology?
or
any of you aware of RFT? Yeah. So can you explain to what is RFT?
Rational Unified Process, actually ThoughtWorks and Ali built that, and it was before Ajay.
Yeah, it's also an attraction model type, right?
It's
CBI
and
Ajay.
See whether RUP is better than Ajay or not. I'm personally a fan of RUP. Okay? See, we can talk.
Rational tools, I think. Not supported others.
Yes, correct. Yeah, she got the point exactly. Yes, see, yeah, see, it's hinged to a tool, that's its disadvantage. But then his point is also right, no? Agile also, no? If you really remove all the masala out of it, right? Agile is also about iterative.
Yeah, both have the commonalities.
Correct. See, there are commonalities, but as she said, there are disadvantages.
Yeah, failing fast is also in the RUP.
Yes, yes. Yes. See, there are some similarities, but then it's different.
That's more process heavy, whereas this one talks about people over processes. That's possibly one way of looking at it.
Okay, what we do? I'm not an expert in many things, right? Organizational transformation consultants, do you know their charges? Per hour, $3,000. We have seen some people like them. So what we did, this is a transformation, right? So it's very critical. And this transformation has a larger impact on the industry, academia, one of the best universities. And if you vote for Agile, right, of course many other universities, see, we benchmark universities against each other, right? Other universities may say, okay, they have gone this way, let's go this way, right? Then it becomes a chain effect. So we wanted to be very clear. What we did, we got Dave Snowden on our board, actually. Have anybody heard of Professor Dave Snowden? Okay, so I had the privilege of meeting him. I think you should know more about him. When you search about him, he is considered to be one of the, if not the best, one of the best on-demand thinkers in the world. Okay, for example, IBM, okay, mother of all software organizations, right? So he did everything in the world. Then Google comes, Facebook comes, starting salary 60 lakhs, 70 lakhs. Great engineers go to Google, Facebook, IBM. Though it's doing very well, no, it's going in a, see, the curve is not going up, the curve is going stable. They need some kind of transformation. Whom do they talk to? Whom do they engage? Dave Snowden. Transformation. Okay, one of the best on-demand thinkers. Okay, you have a social problem. For example, in Singapore, 30 years before, right? Small, tiny red dot, right? Where we live. Challenges are very high. Now everything is available in Singapore. Okay, but 30 years before, the kind of students had all the challenges when they grow up, right? Water issues, this. Okay. Typically like a backward country. Now everything is available at doorstep. So his suggestion is, right, so your current students don't have challenges to a greater extent. So he advised the government, all your best students, okay, from Raffles Institution, don't put them to law school, medical school. Put them in Africa. Ask them to do 6 months internship. See, this is an alarming finding. 6 months internship where they soil their hands. See, that's where now I find, no, Indian students coming holistic and doing very well because, right, they go through all the cycles, right? You have to really know what's wrong, what's right by doing it, not by hearing it. Okay, having water is good. Hearing it, okay, it may not stimulate you. But being in a bad environment and moving to a good environment will stimulate you. So he's a kind of guy who, okay, advised organizations, governments, everything. So we took him to really ask him, how to do this transformation journey. See, his suggestions, no, 3-4 suggestions, he told, encourage chaos. Okay, many faculty pool are there, right? Call them, say, no, this is how it needs to happen, then see what happens. Okay. And Hercule Poirot novels, if you're reading, no, I'm very fond favorite of that. In fact, I've written some travel journals and published it as well, as books. He says, right, when you, see, assume I collect all 10 of you and make you speak on a common topic, right? And you open up your mind and keep speaking. After 10 to 15 minutes, right, you turn inward generally and then start to speak about yourself. So when generally people are allowed to work in an uninhibited environment, after a point in time, right, they turn inward and then they start getting genuine. They start opening up and then telling more. Okay. He told, create such kind of a chaotic environment, allow people to really go down and then they'll come back with their suggestions. Okay. That is one thing we did. Be unclean for a while in the sense that don't go by expert approach. Okay. Go by this is how it will work. Go by the rule book telling this is how it will work. Then I told how rule book will work. Agile is about breaking rules, right? Then he told a different example and explained it to me, which I personally realized also. Okay. Sometimes following rules are great and good. For example, right, when I was cleaning up and moving from Pune to Chennai before relocating to Singapore, I had to drive my new car. Okay, I had only 1.5 days in hand, which is a real example. I had 1.5 days. I didn't want to move it through a transporter. There are some variables also that needs to be carried. But then I have a flight to catch in 1.5 days itself. See, it's around 30 hours I have in hand. So it was critical. So everybody said you cannot make it, because around 1200 kilometers from Pune to Chennai, I'm not a great driver. Okay, you need a break in the night. Okay, they said you're not going to make it, just put it through a transporter. So my calculation was, if I have to reach in one day, what are the rules I have to follow? If I drive fast, I'll get tired, then I'll have to sleep, right? So why do I have to drive fast? Driving fast is what, 100 plus? I said always 80, regardless of whether the road is empty or full. Okay, what are other rules? I don't eat much, only tea, whatever. Okay, see, with these simple rules, right, I reached in 21 hours, to be very honest. But then I would have reached in 19 hours. I spent extra 2 hours because, right, from Pune, I start today evening 5 o'clock. I ride at 80. Same speed throughout I'm going. Only tolls are, because there are hundreds of tolls, they are delaying me. As I go forward, right, I'm crossing Bangalore, then I'm crossing Velur, then I came across Vaniyambadi, world's best biryani they have. Okay, I got very tempted, then I ate it, no? Then I had to sleep for 2 hours. Breaking the rule, okay, put me in that place. So I was able to reach. So he told, no, say rules will work in certain cases. First, tell them that Agile is going to work. Okay, let them believe in it. So such kinds of things. Then what we did, we looked at the standard hype cycle. Okay. See, generally many technologies, what happens is, no, it goes through a period of positivism, then it goes down, right? So whether Agile is really a hype or reality is what we wanted to find out. Is Agile here to stay forever? That's again another question we had in mind. See, how many of you are aware of Gartner hype cycle? I think almost all of you, right? This is a paid report which you can get. For 1 year, I think they publish it twice. Almost all happening technologies are populated here. Okay. So I took the example of July 2012, where, no, if you see here, Agile is starting its journey in the slope of enlightenment. Okay. See, this is Agile here. Okay. From an industry and academic perspective, right, whenever you see a technology or a model being populated here, no, it is starting to cruise now. So the next 10 to 20 years, I think it's going to go there. Well, okay, this is a slope of enlightenment actually. So that is one very important point which told, okay, Agile is going to happen in a big way. See, we also consulted Barry Boehm's, sorry for the figure, it's a big, maybe you can refer later, where he said, right, in his work on 21st century software engineering trends, he told Agile is going to be at the center of everything. Okay, so we are getting the background ready now. Okay, best of the people like Barry Boehm says, okay, Agile is going to happen. Gartner hype cycle says, okay, Agile is the way. Dave Snowden votes for it. If somebody says, okay, Yahoo adopts Agile, Google adopts Agile, we don't take it. Okay, we are ready to pay anything to get into Yahoo and then really sit and see, is it done in a structured way? Because we need results which are verifiable. So that way, Accenture, Cisco, Dell, Google, Yahoo, our study was, no, they are really reaping benefits out of implementing Agile. We at least studied around 30 top organizations. I've given a sample here. Then finally, what we did, bring the context down. Okay, see the Gartner hype cycle, see what the famous experts say, see what the industry says, whether industry is actually following it and reaping benefits or not. Look at what universities are doing. Then what more is there? Only see what Singapore is doing. So we engaged two of our students, okay, with consultation from an industry expert and one of our professors. Okay, and then, no, see, we got around 63 responses from 24 companies in Singapore, where no, interestingly, forget that 14%. They say, okay, I'm an agile team and then I did something in agile. But the rest of the people, right, 43% here and then 43% there, they really told we don't know anything about agile. This happened somewhere, the survey happened somewhere in 2010-2011. Okay, so we saw there is a potential market as well, right? Almost everybody is telling we don't know anything about agile. And then the agile methods usage like extreme programming, Scrum, here also we noted that there is a lot of potential for agile. Okay, kind of a conclusion. In summary, okay, all this painstaking work, right? You may think, okay, agile conference is happening, agile is a buzzword, why this guy went and did a survey on agile, all these things. For university, it's different. Stable, verifiable results, then we change the curriculum, right? So when I'm going to tell you, okay, agile is great, you can really believe my word, okay, because that kind of analysis is done. Then what we did, we summarized, and then we found top organizations adopt agile consistently. Universities are starting to include agile subjects cautiously. Mark this word, not in like industry. Okay, and there is a lot of potential for agile teaching locally in Singapore and also internationally. Some of the inferences we made are agile approach, agile transformation with cautious optimism. Agile is here to stay. It's not just a hype. Industry adoption of agile is ahead of compared to academics. Academics have to catch up. Agile demands inclusion in both. It demands inclusion in both core and elective subjects. This is a final decision we took. So I remember I talked about M.Tech core and elective, right? So our conclusion now is we have to change it. Okay. See, why I am coming and presenting inside data? No, we have. Of course, we expected very less participants here. Okay, but then no. If any of you had any view telling no, your approach is wrong. Right, it's a very important signal for us, right? Because being an university, and then when we want to change things really, right? Industry feedback is very valuable.
One question I have: yeah. When you talk about agile methodology, you looked into all agile methodology or only Scrum?
Scrum is okay.
One of the agile. There are many other methodology. So whether you looked into all other?
See, for us, see if it's a 400-page book, right? See, I'm giving a straightforward answer to you. Scrum is 4 pages in it. That's the reality, right? But then, no, what happens is some courses which are very marketable, right? For example, Scrum Master course, right? So people get trained in Scrum, then they say Scrum methodology is nothing but Agile. It's just a tiny, as you rightly said, just a tiny part of the whole Agile universe. We considered everything under the Agile portfolio.
So your curriculum is going to give a good stuff so that the student will learn about all the different techniques.
Yes. See, you will actually see the curriculum now,
yeah,
and then criticize it for a particular elective. Okay. See, we ended here, right, with a summary. Now what happens? See, this is kind of a roadmap, current state, what I created. In M.Tech Software Engineering, we decided we are going to introduce Agile Project Management elective and then have a research elective using Agile. One of the first, not only organizations, universities in the entire globe to drive research through agile methodology will be us. Okay. Have you heard of any research setups using agile methodology? No, right? So core units will have to be upgraded in agile topics. Student projects should follow iterative development approach. This is a safer approach we took. Because no student project, if you say agile, they are attached in the industry. And then if they go and ask their industry managers, can we do agile approach, Scrum, this, that? No, it's not working out. So we said we'll cautiously do only iterative development approach for student projects. And then we said we'll roll out several short courses. Continuous delivery, agile engineering, answering your question, agile requirements, agile certified practitioner, agile leadership. This doesn't mix Scrum Master course, of course. Pete Dimmer is, as I said, no, we are industry focused, right? I think many of you would have heard of Pete Dimmer, right? When we say we do, it doesn't have to be we actually teaching it. We can engage a lot of people. Okay, Pete Dimmer does currently the Scrum Master course for us. Okay, continuous delivery, who does it for us? ThoughtWorks. But then the decision to engage these people is taken in a structured way. That's the roadmap I showed you. If you really look at, no, where our M.Tech was and where it is now, look at the background work that was done. Any of you coming in and questioning me, hey, your curriculum is agile oriented, is it really meaningful? I have an answer for it. Okay, so that's the background. We also told we will get into a lot of agile consulting, like transformational roadmap journey, stuff like that. Lot of research and publication on agile. So this is kind of a roadmap, go ahead plan.
So this curriculum is primarily focusing on agile, nothing else, right? Or it is just one of the elective subject?
Okay, see the background is right. We have a MTech software engineering program.
Correct. Yeah.
Okay. This curriculum goes and hits that software engineering curriculum. MTech software engineering will remain the same, but all agile oriented stuff will go into that curriculum.
But you told in the beginning, like us, you are not planning to teach software development lifecycle waterfall now.
Yes.
So in place of waterfall, you are replacing with agile.
Correct. Correct.
So only waterfall is replaced. Rest all will continue to be there, right?
See it this way. You are right. Mm-hmm. When it comes to a software development lifecycle model, waterfall is replaced by agile methods,
correct.
Right? When it comes to design, then agile approach comes in.
Okay.
Okay. I think you have attended a lot of sessions from Linda Rising, Mary Popatic, right? They talk about kind of this. So design changes. Then your testing changes. Test driven development comes. Okay. So every phase of the teaching changes accordingly. It's a big challenge for us, right?
So this is Scrum Master course is targeting whom? And the people who are having industrial experience or the student who is coming out of the institute?
MTech is for students.
Yeah.
Short courses is for industry.
For industry, okay, not for a student.
Yes. Not for the student. Means students can also attend it, but then it's primarily focused on industry.
Okay.
See, that's why I told we are not only a teaching organization.
Mm-hmm.
We are a consulting organization. We do a lot of short courses, everything. Okay. But then all the money we earn, it's not a profit intent.
Right.
The idea is not to earn money because we are funded by the government directly. See, elective, what happened? I have given a snapshot. See, several electives are there, right? We have introduced new electives now. In advanced IT management, agile software project management, I will be teaching that elective inside NUS. Heavy nominations for this. Okay, then naturally we understand people are very interested in it. And then we have introduced two electives on advanced IT topics 1 and advanced IT topics 2, which is primarily doing some research work. Okay, I'll tell you what
exactly is that agile software project management, because that is contradicting with our understanding. We talk about product owner role, we talk about a scrum master role.
Yes.
So what exactly is software project management then? Agile software project management.
See, I'll come to it in few minutes. Hold your question for few minutes. I am opening this entire course design to you. Generally, that's not done. Then you can tell whether it will work or not, because the course is happening only in September. It's fresh and hot.
Okay.
Okay. If you are telling Jagadish this is not the way it needs to be, no, it's very valuable feedback for me.
Because none of the speakers here talk about software project management in Agile. They start with the product backlog, they then talk about sprint backlog, scrum master.
But all of that is part of project management, isn't it?
So if you are telling, we are clubbing all of them together and telling the curriculum name is project management, then it's fine, it makes sense.
Yeah, I think it will come out in a few
seconds. It's an oxymoron, right? Agile project management.
Correct, yeah.
See, do you know
how many people say in Agile we don't need a project manager?
Yes.
Second, we are teaching Agile software project management, so people may say, is it contradicting?
It's a good suggestion. Maybe I should change the name of the elective itself, right?
Right.
But I did a survey in LinkedIn. I used all my contacts, many very very famous industry people doing agile stuff like that. Most of the people told this topic stinks. What is agile software project management? Okay, it contradicts. But then we retained it for a different reason.
Okay.
See, industry can use bombastic words, no? When it comes to university, no, we are very soft in our approach. Agile gave second life to our dormant research elective. Okay, research, no? Assume you are from industry, you are coming to do MTech software engineering. You don't want to do much. All you want to do is learn certain things and go away. If we ask you to do some fundamental research, no, you get very irritated, right? So generally for this elective, nominations will be won. And interestingly, we had the best faculty teaching that elective. So at least I have 4 or 5 people here now, no? Assume our great professor is teaching, I don't want to name him, with only one student. He has to run a semester, no? How? It's very difficult, right? So, but then when we moved it to Agile, we said we'll drive it through agile method. No, students started getting interested. This year we are having 25 students reading it. So it's an indication that anything can be done through agile. Okay. So the focus was to deliver a proof of concept prototype or a minimum viable product. Okay. Why I've highlighted this is minimum viable product means what? We work with a lot of CEOs also. CEOs not like CEOs at IT companies. Okay. CEOs who are working in, who are studying in business schools. For example, second year MBA student having a great idea. He came out with an idea. Glaucoma patients, right? They have to put eye drops. They keep forgetting it. This eye, how many drops? This eye, how many drops? Can there be an app in iPhone telling them? In Taiwan, people are obese. Can there be an app reminding them that you have to eat less? Simple things, right? Okay. So these days, right, how new CEOs are coming up with ideas is they don't create a business plan, go to industry, ask for funding. Then after the business plan is approved, they get funding, they do. That cycle is gone now. Because we have an incubation hub where we also encourage a lot of CEOs to come up inside the university. Where what I find is, right, you have an idea, workable idea, you go to the market, do something with it. Then the idea sells, then you get funding. Business plan comes in later, it doesn't come at front these days. Okay. So our research students, right, for example, the glaucoma idea, can you build a minimum viable product which can go into the market? So it's very market focused. How we did it is, here we use Scrum. 6 to 8 students, one faculty advisor. Okay, they have set of requirements, then they do things.
So your research program is already in progress or it is to be started? Research on agile.
See, it has gone through 2 cycles already.
It's already gone through
two cycles.
And what's the duration of each cycle?
Yeah, see, it is 2 electives put together.
Okay.
Okay, meaning 2 semesters. Totally, it comes to around 100% of effort of 6 students coming together actually.
And what are the research topics per se? What are they research on?
Anything under the sun. As long as it's not through a regular cycle. For example, right, some of the research projects, like we did park tap, where I am in a park, I want to find where I am actually.
Okay.
See, always remember, these are ordinary engineering students who worked in IT in different roles, coming back to university. They want to make it big in their life. Okay, of course, our qualifying criteria is very, 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 very tough. But when they come in, no, we look for learning ability only. We don't look for IT skills and knowledge. So we don't have that criteria. When they come in, right, they're able to create wonderful products like this. Anything that is interesting and that is not explored so far is our research idea. Okay. Then they do this. See, when they go back.
So they, sorry to interrupt in with you. So let's say they pick up a topic that they want to locate a place in the park, right? So how do they do agile? They do their research and iterations, that's what you are saying? Or do they do any research on agile? Let's say they want to do research on Scrum. So what is the research? Is it on Scrum or is it on?
You're right. See, good question. See, it is not agile is predefined. Okay. Agile is a technique to move towards your solution. It's like a torchlight here.
Yes.
They don't research on agile. What they do is they use agile for their research. For example, I have to build a park tap application. It has 5 features. So we call that, we make a product backlog out of it.
Oh.
Students come together, then it's like a software project.
I got it. Thanks.
See, our transformation journey of MTech, right? Kind of emergency entrance never works for us. Okay, we do it patiently and then slowly. How we successfully did it is, having a structured approach, it helps us back early management buy-ins, get staff concurrence, provide definite purpose and plan to our journey. Now everybody is in the same page. Continuous reflection is also the key. We have something called a reflection journal for students, even for faculty. Today also when I go back, right, I look at why there are few attendees here, why certain questions are coming up actually. So this journal, okay, readings from it also help. Even traditionalists will vote for change if it is orchestrated as an inclusive journey. We have some PhDs who are teaching the same subject for 25 years. Asking them to change this particular way is a huge, huge challenge. But then if you include him as part of the journey itself, right, then it's very easy to transform them. These are our learnings. Following an adaptive process, this again agile preaches, right? look at where you are, what you know, and then find a way.
Okay.
Lastly, data speaks for itself if it is relevant. If the data is crap, right? For example, we collect a lot of data from industry telling, okay, all top companies are doing agile. It doesn't work. We have to specifically tell in Accenture, this is the method, and then it seems to yield results. Then they will ask us, can you please pass on the data to me? Okay, so it goes that way. So this is about MTech transformation. Okay. So I'll see, the next part is very important for me. Right? You are going to wear the hat of a criticizer here, not as a learner. You asked about the project management elective, right? This is what we are going to do. We want to fail fast and go the agile way. Okay, I think first time in the history of university somebody is coming and opening a course design even before teaching it. Okay. If you cannot give feedbacks now, offline also you can send me feedbacks. I will consider all those things. Assume I am taking your feedback and then changing a part of it. There will be attribution to it. Okay. From this person, this is what was there. Correct, right? Because we cannot own credit which we don't create. This course, what is the aim? Agile project management. See, in industry, there are several courses, right, for Agile. Even in these talks, right, some people talk of management mindset, this, that. There is no one course connecting everything, right? For example, if we do an appraisal, in Agile, we tell 4 to 5 people work together. But in an appraisal, we say this guy got higher rating, this guy got lower rating, right? So there is an appraisal issue in an Agile environment. So HR comes in. Management has to be convinced for an Agile journey to happen, right? If the management is having a fixed mindset, if you do a lot of scrums, Agile journey at the lower level, still it doesn't work. So there should be a course which connects from top to bottom. That's the aim of this course. That's why it's very powerful. Okay. It should be an A to Z approach, starting and sustaining an Agile journey in an organization. How to learn a specific Agile management tech, meaning learning Scrum helps, but then it's not everything, right? Scrum is only one piece of many things together in Agile. We wanted an exclusive, it's like a biblical course. Okay, I want to learn about Agile project management, everything is here. So, this will be a 5-day elective course. Okay. See, our technology is very different. The way we teach, right? It's totally different. It's extremely dynamic. For example, I'll give you how we are going to teach this elective. We'll create dynamic question backlogs. Nobody will come and write in the board. Every student has a mobile configured, right? So when we teach as staff, right, assume you have this particular question. I'm running you through this course. Assume at the end of 30 minutes you felt, okay, this is not working. Jagadish has to work in a different way. One way is to stop me and then suggest. Another way is just type it. Okay, there will be a screen. All the questions will be flashing up. Okay. Meaning, just like a product backlog, we'll create a question backlog, we'll pick up certain questions and then we'll teach, which will be very dynamic learning experience. Okay, that is one part. Agile storytelling by Dr. Robert Frith. Okay, you talk about the history of mankind. We have Dr. Robert Frith, who's a Cambridge scholar, Oxford PhD. He was one of the, I would say, great journeyman who worked in Carnegie Mellon University. You would have heard of CMMI model, everything, right? He was a driver behind it for several years, but he always believes in working from back. You would have heard a lot of names at the front. Dr. Robert Frith is a great scholar who was in SCI for many years before joining our department. I am co-teaching this course along with him. Okay, what is his job? Come and tell stories, agile story. Okay, when was the first agile lesson happened? Maybe it happened 800 years back in a war. Okay. So it's a story, it's kind of a video presentation. He's very, very, very good in it. So first half a day he comes, tells agile stories, shows videos, creates mindset. He's kind of, if you want to tag me, he's kind of a Linda Rising kind of a guy. If you go to our presentation, no, you may think nothing happens, but there's a transformation happening inside you. That's the way she presents, right? So I put him at top for him to tell agile stories. We also wanted to build instinctive agile skills. Okay. Example is an eagle's nest story. I wrote an article on it. For example, right, when I was in Chandigarh, okay, we used to have an eagle's nest. So, how does eagle build a nest? In a V-shaped branch, right, it always puts a nest, lays its eggs. assume a storm comes also, it doesn't, nothing happens. So eagle is one of the most agile birds, right? It can just fly in at great speed, come and sit on it actually. One day great storm happened, okay, but then the nest remained intact actually. I was so intrigued how this method works for them. Then no, we did some search. Search means not research, some Google search, and then find even in California, right, eagles build nest the same way. Across the globe, anywhere in any tree, if you see, you know, eagles follow a particular process approach for building. Then my next question was, okay, see, mother eagle leaves the eaglet when it is only 3 months old. It's not teaching anything to the eaglet, right? How to build a nest or whatever. Because my mother is gone, I don't have any formal education. Still, when I grow up and I get married, I'm able to build the same nest, right? So, bulk of nature's lessons are instinctive. We should not teach agile only in a classroom environment. We should trigger the agile instincts in the students actually by a lot of exercises, workshops. So we understood that, we built our workshops that way. Okay. Singapore driving license example. Okay. See, getting a driving license in Singapore is a big pain, to be very honest, right? Because there are millions of rules to follow. Okay. But then I got the license in only 2 days, the 2 days preparation. Why? All the questions tie back to only one basic fundamental concept for a Singapore driving license. I am revealing that. Okay. So, pedestrian, for example, right, I am having green light, I am going in a car. Pedestrian crosses the road, for him it's a red light. What should I do? I should still stop because it's a human life. So, there are cases from all angles. Okay. Car is going, pedestrian is crossing. Something is happening, pedestrian is crossing. Whether he has the right of way or whether he doesn't have the right of way, fundamental concept is you have to allow him to go, whether he has done a mistake or not. If you get this concept, 20 out of 30 questions you can answer correctly. But then if you always go by rules, it's gone. So I got the fundamental concept. So similar to a Singapore driving license example, now what is the core tenet of agile? We want to teach that because we are talking of a larger topic, right? So all those values we wanted to give. Okay. So there are some more examples, becoming a millionaire. Okay. See, there was a workshop which I attended. Okay, where I won the first.
Oh, we have 3 more minutes, so we'll be able to
finish. Yes, yes, we are near the end. So there was a workshop where I attended, no, becoming a millionaire was the workshop actually, where I was given a case of attire. Generally I don't believe in attire, okay. I come with very poor attire actually. Unfortunately they gave the topic. It's like a lightning talk where I am given 2 minutes. See, is it okay if I overrun by 5 minutes? No problem.
There is some
presentations
here. Yeah. Told everyone. Okay. So maybe in a couple of minutes I finish. See, what happened? My socks were torn that time. Okay. What I just removed my shoes. I didn't make any preparation. Then I told, no, if you want to become a millionaire, get up and then jump 10 times. Okay. You believe my word. Then no, everybody looked at this only. Then I told, okay, if you have to be a believer of something, right, the person who is telling it will have, I am like a beggar with a hole here. So there is a connect here, right? Okay. So I told attire is that important. So it's as simple as that. Then my message was very clear. So stuff like that, SMS live voting. So we'll use several mechanisms to teach stuff. Okay. Objectives of the course I have given. Okay. You need to understand the core agile values, principles, practices, how to create a business case. Understand agile project management from leadership, role, estimation, practices, agile lifecycle, everything. Agile software lifecycle, SDLC, how to do. Gain understanding of agile practices, all the practices. Agile project delivery frameworks like Scrum, Agile Unified Process, DSDM, everything. Okay. What? See, I think we won't have time to discuss and criticize this. This is available. Okay, maybe you can look at it offline and then say, Jagadish, this topic may work or may not work. I'll take the feedback. Okay, so we give an introduction to Agile with lot of examples. How to do business case? What is Agile leadership governance? Agile development practices. You asked that question, right? Test-driven development, refactoring, feature-driven, everything comes in. Okay, it's a heavily packed course. Scrum Master course, you do it for 2 to 3 days, right? Here in 5 days, we do several things. So the course has to be taught in a very, you have to learn it from an uncluttered mind, otherwise everything will be confusing. So agile modeling, everything. Okay, Agile SDLC framework, Agile, finally how to realize benefit out of doing Agile in an organization. Okay, how to be a believer, we have several examples. I finish with speaking about my very good friend, Dr. Kumaran Rasappan, right? Getting a medical seat in Singapore is like, it's an impossible thing, only the best students get it. Okay, this guy was a doctor, meaning studying, at the end of the third year, right, he wanted to climb Everest, he left everything, went and came back. He believed really in what he wanted to do. So that kind of belief system is required. Okay. So closing note, we are a not-for-profit setup. Okay, please give your feedback to us offline. Thank you.